Hello everybody, it's Tim Spector here of the Zoe COVID Symptom Study app, giving you the week's update, and there's quite a lot to go through. So there's some general good news because the government has changed the rating of alert in the UK from a 4 to a 3, recognising, as we did several weeks ago now, that the threat of COVID is diminishing and restrictions will continue to ease. And this has happened despite a small recent uptick in cases, which we can discuss as we go through this. Now, while COVID is adapting to our population, we're also adapting to COVID, and infections have actually changed. Now, if you've had, like many of the other people using the app, over 80% now, had one or two doses of the vaccine, your risk of catching the virus is much lower, but there's still a chance you'll get it. And what we do know is that your symptoms will be much milder. And we've had a quick look at the latest data, not in any great detail, because my team at King's will be presenting this as a preprint next week. But just to give you a few facts about it, we are showing that it's much harder to detect than it was before the vaccine. And you may even think you've just got a cold, or even in many cases have no symptoms at all, because we think the asymptomatic rate is really going up very rapidly. And we're seeing far fewer people with the classic symptoms. If you remember the shortness of breath, the cough in particular, but also loss of smell, and fewer symptoms overall. So as a comparison, that this gets milder, even milder after two doses. So it's like reasonably severe, the cold COVID we knew in the past, where on average you might get five symptoms in that first week, to getting perhaps two to four symptoms in the after one dose, and really zero to one after you've had two doses. So this is really making quite a big difference, because it's obviously hard to know if you've had the disease, you're getting the much less of the classic symptoms, and this is going to have a big effect, because the good news, although it's harder to detect, is that it's going to have much less chance of being admitted to hospital, because you won't have the chest problems as likely as before vaccination. It doesn't last as long, therefore you're not going to be debilitated and be off work for as long, and we think that you're less likely to develop long COVID as well. So all this is good news. And so it has to be a much less effect on the NHS. And we've got this paper next week. We'll go into much more detail also about working out what the risk factors are for still getting COVID after infection, because there are clear differences between people emerging. So keep a lookout for that. So it's important to keep logging your symptoms even after a vaccine. Now, you remember for the last few weeks we've been mentioning we're about to change our methodology to give you the latest, most accurate results, and also allow us to do this in real time, unlike some of the other surveys that have more complex methods. And we need to do this because now over 80% of the app users have been vaccinated, and this is greater than the equivalent population of the UK that we generalize our results to. So we've put an adjustment in these figures, and you can see this in the new results, which generally are showing exactly the same trends as you can see in the graph, but at around 1,000 cases per day greater. This doesn't really affect any of these conclusions, just that the basal rate, because it's much milder and harder to detect, is more likely to be around this 2000 mark. Now, figures have gone up in the last week, and in not only in our data, but also in the government confirmed cases. Our data suggests it's as high as 65%, although there are very wide confidence limits around that because the numbers are so small. So we're going to keep a close eye on that and see if that is of concern next week. But the good news is that most of these cases are either very mild in the over 50s who have been vaccinated, or they are occurring in the younger population that have generally much milder disease. But we'll keep an eye on that, and this is probably just due to the relaxing of lockdown, which, as long as it doesn't have major health consequences, should be fine. Now, always good to look at this in context, because our figures are still as low as they were last summer. We still have one of the lowest rates in Europe, as you can see from this chart. We're still down there with Israel, and been recently joined by Portugal. But you can see the other countries that have had previous problems, like France, Italy, Spain, are coming down nicely. And if you look at those trends, they should be at similar levels to us in about a month's time. So again, that should be good news for the summer. Now, let's talk about vaccines. Vaccines are definitely working, and that's why we're getting less cases, milder cases, and clearly less transmission of the virus. So we need to keep vaccinating and to keep being aware of the risks and benefits of this vaccination as we go on. And over a million of you have given us your data, and we're, as soon as we're getting it, we're feeding it back to you. And we now have 6,900 people who have given us their data on the Moderna vaccine. And we've been looking at the side effects of that compared to the other big two vaccines that most of you have been used to. And the good news is that the rates of side effects are still really low, and most people are not getting anything serious, and problems are only lasting a few days. The profile does seem to be more similar to the Pfizer jab, such that painful arm is probably the most common side effect, and these fatigue and headaches and these other common symptoms are also there. So we're keeping an eye on that, and at the moment there are really little differences in the type of side effects people are getting, although headache does seem to be slightly commoner in the AstraZeneca jab. And again, your age makes a big difference to these side effects. Now, because we are dynamic and always adjusting our results and figures and giving you the latest in real time, we've also revised our estimates of your current risk based on these new data. They haven't really changed dramatically. It's still very low, but if you're unvaccinated, it's around 1 in 16,000. If you've had a single jab, it's 1 in 32,000. And if you've had two jabs, it's 1 in 46,000. And again, the more you've been vaccinated, the milder and often asymptomatic the disease will be. We're also launching a brand new feature, because I know you've got lots of questions for me and I can't answer them all on Twitter or email. And we know there's lots of things on your mind at the moment. So we're giving our loyal app users a direct line in. And so we've set up a platform for you to be able to ask me and all the other scientists at Zoe and at King's behind the app what those questions are. And so we'll choose a few of these to answer every week. So do keep an eye out on the app and the website. And don't worry if your question doesn't come up. There's plenty of other opportunities. So anyway, thanks for trusting us with your data. as we knew into this new phase of a milder COVID. And I'm sure we're going to get through this very well together, but we'll do this by understanding it. So thanks for logging and stay safe.